Pull up Thermax too. Let's see how the reaction is with regard to the numbers. No major reaction. The stock's trading at 1,042. And talking about the numbers, the company saw its profit rise 13% in the third quarter. Well, margins also improved, but not across all verticals. Order balance has also taken a hit in the October to December quarter. So are there any signs of macro environment improving? And in turn, this could be aiding Thermax. Let's put this question to Mr. MS Unnikrishnan, who joins us from Pune. Hi, Mr. Unnikrishnan. Good morning and thanks a lot for joining us today on Bloomberg Quint. There is some margin expansion and we were just talking how in quarter three that's turning out to be a theme because there is slowdown in the economy, but most of the companies have managed to cut down on their expenditure. And in your case, we've seen the other expenses coming off for the December quarter gone by. But net-net, your major segment, that's the environment segment, that's not done well. Could you take us through the highlights of the quarter and what were the bottlenecks you faced?
Well, let me start on with the order intake. It had been, on one side, comforting. Other side, little disturbing. The comforting factor is the overall order intake for the quarter has gone up by around 9%. Going up from 1430 to 1600 crores, which is a positive to talk about. But what is a little negative in that is environment segment is the one which has helped us to have an improvement in the order intake, especially the FGD order that we've been able to pick up from one of the power companies. Otherwise, on the overall order intake, I would have been better off in case if I could be getting more orders from the domestic market. I need to be confirming that order finalizations both in the infrastructure area as well as in the consumer facing industry had not been up to the mark in the last one quarter. We may be one of the better off companies to be possibly reporting an order intake better than the previous year. So that is point number one. On revenue side, it is almost flat. A minus 2% is here or not there. That makes you feel under that. There again, there were no major execution challenges. However, the customers aren't as pushy in the current circumstances to complete the project on time. It is our push and execution ability which has even been able to bring it to a level where almost closer to last year's same quarter. Fourth quarter, I'm hopeful that market may be improving. Otherwise, there were no customer pressure for execution. Not that I have piled up any inventory. In fact, my inventory has come down only because we have been very prudent in managing the balance sheet. On the profit side and the EBITDA, we had been able to improve. Though at the PBT level, you may find a little lower, but net PAT level, of course, certainly it has gone up in comparison to last year and is a better YTD level also. That's overall about it. But the markets are not sounding very good. I was expecting the post scenario of the budget, maybe the sentiment should turn around. So let's wait and watch, Neeraj.
Sir, could you spoke about the order inflow. Can you tell us then, for 9 months now, how's the inflow been and what's the outlook going ahead and where would you end FY20 at with regard to order? And also if you could share a guidance then, looking at the current macro environment.
See, the order intake for the first 9 months of the year is 4,300 crores rupees in comparison to 4,400 odd. So it's just about a minus 4% in comparison to previous year. I am hoping that I should be able to hit the last year's number at least, which is not the case with the industry because majority of the industry currently is other than those who are working in the road building equivalent of that. Everybody is complaining about order reduction. So I may be able to meet up with the last year's number, which is what we are currently trying for. We only are maybe less than 3 months away from 2 months away, just about February and March to see that. The trend is looking like we should be able to match up with the last year's number. However, what I'm concerned a little more about beyond the Q4, because capital goods companies should not be talking about one quarter, we should be thinking about a little medium to long term. Enquiry pipeline is looking positive for the project side because we got Barmer refinery going to be ordering out in the Q1 of next year. We also have the Gujarat refinery and Panipat refinery also inquiries out in the market. So we will be one of the major players. Of course, there you'll have to bid and win, and bidding and winning in oil sector with very less number of inquiries in the market, there'll be a toughness on the margin going forward, but we'll see how we manage it. Similarly, from the international market also, there are a couple of projects which are moving ahead. My only current worry about projects execution or project order finalization is, how far is the coronavirus issue going to be impacting the global trade? And will there be postponements on account of that in the global market is something which should be seen. If it is going to be, like peaking in the next maybe few weeks and then going to decline, then global trade will not get impacted. But if that were to be piling up beyond a level and spreading across the globe the way people are suspecting, then all of us should be concerned about in the entire industry that we may miss out some time for the global trade itself. So let's wait and watch on that count. Otherwise, I am hopeful that there is nothing like a negative surprise in the budget. That's something which I need to say that. It's all a little medium to long-term thinking articulated. Fairly good amount of money allocated for the various sectoral development, which can have a positive impact on companies like us, provided they are able to go ahead with the projects. So all of us are looking forward to maybe a coming year, where order intake should be improving towards the second half of next year. So that's the overall outlook related to the market.
Mr. Unnikrishnan, good morning. Neeraj here. Just wondering, would the domestic spaces and sunrise pockets, maybe specialty chemicals or some of the others, will not come in and fill in the uncertainty around, one, the domestic outlook, which you said is not really gung-ho post-budget, or the uncertainty around the globe?
See, specialty chemicals should do better, will do better, because the chemical plant is fairly well stabilized right now, which is a difficulty which I found maybe in the beginning, but it is improved. But specialty chemicals cannot fill in the gap that will be left by laxity of larger projects. For example, an FGD order is 400, 500 crore. The entire turnover that I'll be able to do in a year for my chemical business will be around, say, 500-600 crores of rupees in the coming year. So that cannot fill the profitability, certainly. They're really helping us and will continue to be helping. So that should certainly be helping me to ensure that we maintain the margins, even in a very difficult market circumstances where a dog-eat-dog is going to happen, maybe, for the next few quarters with many of the competitors not having sufficient orders. So in that kind of a circumstance, I'll be better off in comparison to my competition with a fairly well-established chemical business also growing faster.
But you are saying unequivocally that it might be futile to try and figure out what the next year could look like, simply because the domestic pipeline has not yet started and the future on the global front remains uncertain because of coronavirus. It's almost impossible to predict right now.
In my opinion, I will be opening the next financial year as a group more or less close to the last year's opening orders. It is not that I won't have any carry forward orders. I should have maybe give or take a 5-10% here and there. The opening order book for the company at the group level should be closer to that kind of number which I mentioned about. If there is no difficulty in executing orders, which I mentioned about corona equivalent or that, I don't think it should be, it may be a lot more of scare than the reality also. Let's for the time being count that way. And our execution abilities, you've seen that we have done even a 2000 crore execution in a quarter. So even if there are some skirmishes, we should be able to manage to execute in the time available. So we are heading for a year where it will not be any dip in the next year. We're targeting that at least we should be able to do what we achieve in the current year or maybe marginally better. So I'm not looking at something negative, but my worry or concern or maybe a challenge is that how do I book more quantum of orders which we are ready for, because I have capacity available, whether it is for domestic market or international market. We are executing projects in every part of the world, in the most difficult Africa to Middle East to South America. So if there are projects available, we would be very happy to pick those orders. But projects should happen. That's all what we are looking forward to.
All right, so execution is not a problem for you right now, but largely most of the companies and economy has been facing those liquidity pressures. Just for your company, sir, could you tell us what are your working capital days and are there any delays in terms of receivables?
Frankly speaking, my overall net working capital requirement, in any case, we don't have any borrowings for working capital, it's only our own funds we are deploying in that, has come down in the last two quarters. We are currently at around 170 crore is the total net working capital that I need to do a business. You can see the kind of size. So we're one of the better of companies where we are very well managed. to do a maybe a 6,000 crore, if I use only 170 crore as a working net working capital, you can imagine many companies will be borrowing maybe a couple of thousand crore to run this kind of a business. That's a prudence that we normally manage. As you mentioned about payment releases are not an easy task in the current circumstance. Even the guys who are plumb with money may want to delay taking the umbrage under the umbrella that there is a cash flow difficulty. I have not come across any substantial cash flow difficulty for my project orders. However, for the MSME sector where I do supply my equipments, their fund flows are under stress on account of the NBFC difficulty, and only those who have got decent balance sheet even in MSME are able to be paying upfront and taking deliveries. So there are pressures on medium sector. When I say MSME, don't look at some very small companies. In India, a 500 crore turnover company, a small chemical company, or somebody who does a food processing of a small nature, fall under MSME nature. And some of them who depend upon NBFCs for their funding may not be in the best of the condition, but we are managing with them because we are very considerate. Because remember, 65% of my orders are coming from the same set of customers, so the repeat orders we do get. So we have internal equations with companies of the kind. It's more of a partnership rather than, we being treated as a supplier and they as a buyer in many, many cases. So we are considerate in many of them. There could be deferred payment terms which you offer to them, which they are able to fulfill also.
Mr. Unnikrishnan, we hope FY21 is better for the company, and we hope we have one more interview with you for quarter four since you stepped down in the month of June. All the best to you for all the interviews that you've given to us and for this transition period.
Thank you.
Okay, that's the management of Thermax. Clearly stated.